Hey, so we've been asked a lot about our audio system. That's why I have the microphone today. And so I'm gonna do a little video about how to explain about also about the languages: Spanish, English, Chinese, French, German. I should know this by heart. Italian and Portuguese. And by the way, Portuguese is Portuguese from Brazil. I'm actually from Portugal, next to Spain in Europe, and the Portuguese is a little different. And we have more tourists coming on a cruise ship by from Brazil. So anyway, the way it works is that we have this system here. It's kind of reflecting a bit, but in the languages. So the driver or the guide actually chooses the language. I'm just gonna choose English because I'm speaking in English today. And they're gonna show you we have 32 loudspeakers. I'm gonna press play.
Welcome to St. Martin Harbor. Here you'll see the aptly named Big Pier, the first deep water pier to be built on St. Martin. The pier was dedicated in 1964, and on December 31st, 2014, the 2 millionth cruise ship passenger set foot on it, marking an important milestone in the tourism industry. Today, tourism is St. Martin's largest industry, but it wasn't always that way. It was the late Dr. A.C. Wadey who led the way in developing the industry that has helped the island nation flourish. And the harbor complex is called the Dr. A.C. Wadey Cruise and Cargo Facilities in his honor.
So we have 8 speakers on each side, which means 16 loudspeakers on the lower deck. And we have also 2 microphones. So this normally is for the guides. And where did I left the other microphone? And the other microphone is or for the a translator, or this one is for the driver, the one I have, because the driver needs to be focused on driving and on. Oh, it's here. I found it. So then also there's this one. This one is. It's not that it's louder. It really depends on who's speaking. Like if I put a little further or closer. So the tour guides manage this individually. But my point is on the. Yeah, I left this open on purpose. So we have 2 amplifiers and 2 MP3s. Like everything is redundant. The idea is to be redundant, and what that means is the redundancy creates the effect that if something breaks during the tour, the redundancy solves that by shutting down one amplifier, turning off the other. We're gonna give you a little example. So here the MP3. You see this MP3 playing? I just have to switch off this one, switch on that one, and automatically the music that you were hearing, that I need to stop speaking to hear the music, will start playing. We have steel pans from Dow, here local steel pans from San Martin, and a mix with Bob Marley. Just kind of like a little mix between pop and local. Then when I speak, the amplifier automatically lowers or fades out the music, so the focus is on what the tour guide is talking. And when I stop speaking, the music comes back again. I'm gonna show you the upper deck where we also have 16 speakers. So you see here, one. Let me show 2, 3, every other row, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 speakers. So if you did the math, it's eight speakers by channel on the amplifier. That's the maximum of the amplifier. And I thought we did have some feedback about the audio in the past, I'll be honest. Because the thing is, on this open air, if the engine reflects on the wall, some noise comes. And also if there's a lot of wind. So imagine you're on a boat. So if you're on a boat, the wind comes and it goes through your ears and you have difficulties hearing, which is normal and it's okay. So I thought, okay, what is the maximum this amplifiers can hold? And it's 8 speakers per channel and the amplifier has 4 channels. I don't want to be too technical because I don't want to bore you. But in conclusion, we have 32 speakers, 32 loudspeakers on each bus. So, yeah. So hopefully that's more than enough. We don't want to be too loud, of course. We want it to the audio to be clear that you will understand. So I'm just gonna put here, for example, in another language, let's say German, why not? Just to wrap up the video, yeah?
They kommen in Häfen von St. Martin. Hier sehen Sie das passend benannte große Pier, das erste Tiefseepier von St. Martin. Das Pier wurde 1964 eingeweiht und am 31. Dezember 2014 ging der 2-Millionenste Kreuzfahrtschiffgast darüber. Dies stellte einen wichtigen Meilenstein des Tourismusgewerbes dar. Heute ist Tourismus der größte Wirtschaftszweig in St. Martin. Aber das war nicht immer so. Es war der verstorbene Dr. A.C. Watty, der maßgeblich dazu beitrug, diese Branche zu entwickeln und die Inselnation damit zu bereichern. Und zu seinen Ehren wurde der Hafenkomplex Dr. A.C. Watty Cruise und Cargo Einrichtung genannt.
So, with this, I sign off on this video. Dankeschön and auf Wiedersehen.